Hey guys, Halfway Dead here. Ever since Rocket League's DirectX 11 support came out, I've been asked to make a video about it. The issue though was that aside from a couple of tests, there isn't really too much I could have said beyond what was in the patch notes. Anything else would have been blind speculation. But then I thought I might as well try and contact Psyonix to see if they are willing to give me a bit more information. And I was pleasantly surprised by what I got back. Before I go over that though, I want to quickly mention that if you enjoy the content, please share it and subscribe. Those things really do help out a lot. My first question to Psyonix was, why was Rocket League switched to DX11? It's more modern, sure, but that alone doesn't warrant the effort. Can we get any information about what is planned with it? Is it to improve multi-threading performance? Are there graphics improvements planned for it? The reply? We switched to DX11 for several reasons, including to have all platforms on Shader Model 5, and to prepare the PC game client for new unannounced features we couldn't previously create while using DX9. While we can't get into the specifics on those unannounced features, they'll be easy to spot in the future. Alright, so this reply was unfortunately not quite as specific as I was hoping, but I totally understand why they're not ready to give out information on planned features early. Either way, it does let us know there are unannounced graphics features coming. The mention about the shader model is relevant for saving the devs some time, although I personally don't quite understand it as DirectX and the related shader model are Microsoft technologies that shouldn't be able to run on PlayStation or Switch. If you know anything more about this, feel free to leave a comment. My next question was, will DX9 continue to be supported in the future? We will stop supporting DX9 in Rocket League with an update later this year. Along with the reasons we mentioned previously, we moved to DX11 because it's still supported by hardware manufacturers like Nvidia, AMD and Intel. So when bugs like the recent image sharpening issue pop up, they are still ready and able to release updates to address those bugs. This one is not that surprising. Keeping up two versions just requires a lot of effort and would totally go against many of the reasons why they discontinued the Mac/Linux versions and even why they switched to DX11 in the first place. The game's minimum requirements have also listed DX11 since their last change. Nevertheless, it's good to have confirmation of this from an official source, so we know for sure now. A lot of people probably didn't want to hear that answer because of performance issues with the DX11 version. My next question therefore was, has there been internal performance testing on a multitude of hardware? I've been asked about performance by multiple viewers, but all I could do is report on my own computer. Of course, we did a thorough amount of testing and found similar performance between the DX9 and DX11 clients on much of the hardware our PC players tend to use. The immediate benefits are less hitching, enhanced stability, like taking less time to alt-tab in and out of the game, and a more stable frame rate. That was their official answer. If you go on Reddit, for example, you will see lots of examples of players complaining about the performance. Of course, the players for which it runs fine wouldn't be on there complaining, so this is a biased sample. I can only report what I've heard from different sides, and that has ranged from slightly higher FPS and less hitching to much lower FPS and a ton of stuttering. The trend in general seems to be that the older the computer and most importantly the graphics card is, the worse DX11 seemed to perform. If you do not meet the minimum requirements, then there isn't much that can be done for you. That is the border at which Psyonix decides to officially support your hardware, and if you fall below it, you will have to upgrade when DX9 gets removed. There are players with modern computers, however, that also ran into issues. And I happen to be unlucky or lucky to run into some performance issues that I can tell you about. Initially, I was running DX11 just fine. A couple of days ago, the game seemed to run really bad though, and I genuinely have no clue why it was worse. The DX9 version seemed unaffected. I was able to fix my issues though by uninstalling Rocket League, renaming the folder in my documents, disabling Steam Cloud, and reinstalling the game. I'd say that's worth a try for anyone. If you still run into any issues, make sure to report them to Psyonix now instead of just using DX9 and then being screwed once it gets removed. My own frame rate on DX11 is still measurably lower on average. However, it tends to be less spiky. You can check this kind of information by opening the performance graphs by pressing F10. Last but not least, input lag. I don't test this every patch, but an API change certainly warrants it. I tested my most stable scenario with minimal graphics at 1000 FPS. This gave me 0.5 milliseconds higher input lag than DX9. I then repeated the same at 240 FPS and got 0.7 milliseconds higher input lag. And at high graphics, I also got 0.4 milliseconds more than DX9. This isn't really anything too important, but I still wanted to see if I could narrow down what might be causing the difference. Indeed, it was kind of obvious in the performance graphs. The number you see under GPU is the amount of milliseconds the GPU needs to render one frame. If it needs 0.5 milliseconds longer, then the frame will get displayed 0.5 milliseconds later, causing the input lag difference. This actually means that the input lag of Rocket League DX9 and DX11 are identical, assuming I would get identical performance. Alright, to sum it up, we will see some graphical treats because of DX11 in the future. DX9 will be removed at some point. On modern hardware, DX11 should run similarly to DX9. If it doesn't, try to fix the issues now. And input lag is not an issue as long as the performance is equivalent. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to share it and subscribe. Shout out to my patrons who support me financially. To stay up to date, follow me on Twitter or join my Discord, and I'll see you soon for the next video.